fight as soon as it was made.
Ready?
Knew it was going to be an exciting, entertaining contest. Yamaguchi comes racing across the cage, only to touch gloves, though, for a second time. A low crouch, she's got high guard. Jenny Huang, all action, all movement. That left hand always just pokes out like a piston, long before it makes an attempt to land anything. It's all just tentative stuff at the moment, first half minute of the opening round. 3 5-minute rounds to come.
When Jenny Huang challenged for the belt, she learned a lot about her ability to strike and absorb shots, so she really wants to take that learning that she had from her title fight and transition into here, and she's really made a lot of adjustments in her boxing and her Muay Thai as far as closing the distance, getting close, and then utilizing that judo.
I don't know if you're seeing a difference in Mei Yamaguchi in the structure there, her arms. She looks ripped, more ripped than I've seen her before. And I think Jenny Huang a little bit tentative about being hit by that big right hand. We've all seen the damage it can do, and it was thrown there. And Jenny Huang doesn't want to get too close to that. Lands a left of her own, though, the girl from Chinese Taipei. It was a nice little shot. Lots of movement between these two, exchanging kicks back and forwards, round and round.
You spoke of the physique of Mei Yamaguchi, and she did add a little bit more strength and conditioning to her pre-fight preparation this time around, because she felt she lacked a little bit of the explosiveness in her past contests.
Just got caught with a couple of right hands that weren't particularly hard hitting from Jenny Huang, but she did leave herself exposed there, the Japanese woman. Oh! Was she caught? A little bit of a slip, off balance?
I think it's a little bit of both. A little bit of a leg kick right as she was trying to lunge out, and the leg got taken out from under her just a bit.
Concentration on both faces. Mei catches the leg and then gets to grips, and the knee up to the body. Right hand, a couple of short right hands from Mei Yamaguchi to the left side of Jenny Huang's jaw.
Very calculating fight so far. You can see each fighter is trying to absorb the shot that's taken and then just sort of figure out exactly what's going on and see if they can make adjustments midstream.
Let's see what that is. Oh, good right hand from Mei Yamaguchi. She takes two or three punches back, but the crispness of that right hand was very eye-catching indeed. Now she digs into the body with that right hand as she presses Jenny Huang up against the cage.
You can see the momentum of that right hand actually takes her, and she has to take a few steps forward as she throws that big right hand. That's how much power is put behind that overhand right.
And there you can see that low angle that we've seen in other fights, employed this time by Mei Yamaguchi to press her opponent against the cage so that there's no escape. She's almost 45 degrees there.
This is where Jenny excels. She's stopping the takedown, and she's utilized that judo background more defensively. You can see that base is so agile and stable as she's avoiding the takedown of Mei Yamaguchi.
Mei kneeing to the thigh. She's done that a few times. There it is again, the inside of the left thigh there. Goes for the single leg, and down Jenny Huang goes.
Single leg takedown from Mei Yamaguchi to end up on top. But we've seen it before. Jenny Huang is really dangerous off of her back. Immediately you can see her starting to trap those arms, you know, locking that right arm down there as she's starting to hit her guard up. You can see her trying to threaten an arm bar right there.
Don't grab the fence.
Olivier Coste asking them not to grab the fence. He's talking to Jenny Huang. Final minute of the first round here. Mei Yamaguchi against Jenny Huang in Yangon, Myanmar. The crowd, noisy as they have been all evening. There's more noise to come from them, I can assure you, as the night goes on, but there's plenty for them to be interested in here.
I like how active Jenny is off her back. She's not just sitting there holding her in closed guard. You can see her putting the feet on the hips, constantly throwing up that right leg as she's trying to get that right leg up high onto the back of Mei Yamaguchi, trapping the arm with the left hand, and then she's going to look to throw that left leg up over the neck of Mei Yamaguchi and possibly look for an armbar.
Meanwhile, whenever Mei Yamaguchi can free a left or a right hand, she quickly throws it towards Jenny Huang's head. And she's done that pretty effectively. Final 10 seconds, and listen to the crowd as they realize that this first round is coming to an end. The anticipation of 10 more minutes. Thrilling for everyone. Time. 5 minutes down. How do you see that one, Mitch? It was furious action. There was no respite at all.
A lot of back and forth action, but you can see that Mei, there's that leg kick. That was a possible stumble. Nice clinch position here, engaged in the knee. The clinching was able to get Mei Yamaguchi into a position to secure the takedown. See how she lunges forward in that right hand? That's how much force and velocity is behind that right hand that Mei Yamaguchi throws. The first round, I'm going to give a slight edge to Mei Yamaguchi. She was able to control the top position, deliver ground and pound, and really control the significant striking when they were on the feet.
Tell you what though, great work by our cameraman there and our guys working the instant replay, because you saw four consecutive punches to the head landing from Jenny Huang. So under pressure and often going backwards, she is able to land. And this huge crowd, along with the judges, will be watching this very, very closely as the next 10 minutes unfold.
Ready?
If this one goes the distance,
round two.
It's going to be mighty close. Second round, two strong women with power. Spinning back kick from Jenny Huang, but...
I like how she set that up, Steve. Faked the roundhouse, came around with the left for a hook. It's like a spinning crescent kick. Well done.
I always think when you do that spinning back kick business, you do sometimes expose yourself a little bit, and she did take one or two blows as a result.
The creativity and the adjustments in the striking are there from Jenny Huang. She looks to be utilizing a lot more footwork, not standing stationary, consistently throwing out that jab, and just attacking from awkward angles. Big takedown, and Jenny Huang jumped guard there, possibly threatened a guillotine, but she looks like she's a bit high. Mei Yamaguchi is easily able to throw that off.
That's the creativeness that we've come to expect from Jenny Huang. She doesn't always do the orthodox thing. She's very imaginative in her moves.
Overhand right there again from Mei Yamaguchi. That seems to be her bread and butter when it comes to the striking game.
Yeah, from this position, Mei will, if she can get in close, look to free her hands up, land those punches. The ground and pound is something she's enjoyed already in this contest. And she'll look to throw in those forearms and elbows as well.
You know, with our judging criteria, it's not necessarily the person on top that is winning the round. If you're on bottom and you're threatening submissions and also striking from the bottom, you can actually edge out a lot of the categories from the bottom.
The up kick there is a particularly dangerous move for the person standing up to receive. You should be wary of the go-go platter as well, Yamaguchi.
But I think the entire atomweight division is wary of the go-go plata. Lady Go-Go can throw it up so easily. Nice little half-guard adjustment to prevent Mei Yamaguchi from sliding fully past her guard there.
Right above us here at cage side, and three times now Mei Yamaguchi has picked up Jenny Huang and thrashed her back towards the canvas, and the crowd making noise as she does it. She digs in with right hands as well. Gets her right hand around the throat of Jenny Huang, but doesn't look as if she can do too much damage from there, Mitch.
Really, she's in danger of getting passed. Yup, Mei Yamaguchi was able to use those strikes to the body to pass the guard, but nice adjustment again from Jenny Huang to avoid the dangerous mount position and to stay in half guard.
Not a comfortable time for her, though, in terms of blows to the face. The knees come close once or twice, but it's the left and the right, and that was a superb left punch going downwards. She just thought about drawing back that knee again. She hasn't quite landed it yet, but it's in her mind, and that knee to the head of her grounded opponent is particularly dangerous.
A lot of sneaky strikes coming through from Mei Yamaguchi on top. You can see her not really going for a lot of big, powerful strikes, but a lot of short, crisp punches that are sliding right past the defense of Jenny Huang. Now she's in full mount position. This is a bad spot for Jenny to be, and she's got to create movement. She's got to move those hips just a little bit to get back into half guard.
Arms around the neck, Mitch, to pull her in, but both arms free, and Mei can pound with left and right here.
Yeah, but she's negating the ability for Mei Yamaguchi to posture up like she's doing right now and create that space to drop those punches.
Now she's got her back. Arms underneath the chin. Watch out for the rear naked choke. She hadn't got the second arm on it, and Jenny did well, but the other arm goes round now. This is very dangerous. It could count the tap. Has it? Yes, it is. Mei Yamaguchi has won this one in the second round with just over a minute left. Rear naked choke, and she's back, Mitch, on the title trail.
That's a huge win for Miss Yamaguchi to get a rear naked choke off the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu specialist, Jenny Huang. Huge win here in Yangon. Rear naked choke, Mei Yamaguchi.
What an athlete this 34-year-old woman is. To be fair, she just had the edge in about every aspect of the fight up until this point. Took a right hand there.
Look at this. Here's where Jenny Huang attempted the jump guard into a guillotine, but once it got to the ground, Mei Yamaguchi was able to control the positions. And you can see Jenny Huang wasn't even able to fight the position. That's how deep this choke was. Once she came under the neck, right here, you can just see her lock it up and grab the bicep, and Jenny Huang is forced to tap. Brilliant exhibition.
Improves her record to 16-10-1 with the official decision. Anthony Suntaki.
To present the medal for this fight, we have Mr. Aung Koko, Deputy Managing Director of First National Insurance. Ladies and gentlemen, referee Olivier Coste calls a hold to this battle at 4 minutes of round number two for your winner by submission via rear naked choke, Mei Yamaguchi!
Two really capable women. It was a shame that only one of them would come away with a win tonight. It turns out that it was the Japanese woman, Mei Yamaguchi.
And already the Ryo Goku Goku Gigan is full. Jab early there from Lachkova. High kick from the Russian. Yamaguchi possesses a beautiful overhand right. And with a tall opponent like Lachkova, well, it's tailor-made for that overhand.
Especially because that overhand right is also going to put her in a perfect position to snatch up a single leg as well. So watch for that. Watch her throw that overhand right, drop down, grab that single, turn into a takedown.
Jab right there from Lachkova. An 80% finishing rate for the Russian on a 5-bout winning streak tonight. Yamaguchi, who twice fired unsuccessfully for the atomweight world title, both times came agonizingly close to defeating Angela Lee. You'll see Lee later on tonight shooting for the strawweight world title against Zhong Jinan.
Good takedown defense so far from Lachkova. Able to keep that over-under position, back her up against the cage and separate.
No sign of nerves on Ksenia Lachkova this week around the hotel and all the media engagements. Very comfortable, very relaxed. Comes in with a very good reputation. Just a feeling out process at the moment here for both Lachkova and Yamaguchi. Jab two there from Lachkova, sitting behind the reach. How does Mei Yamaguchi overcome the height differential here, Mitch?
She's got to try to get into that range. She's got to try to get into that boxing range before she can start throwing some of these hands. She's having a hard time dealing with the range of Lachkova, and Lachkova's doing a good job of keeping her at bay with that jab and keeping that distance off. Watch the footwork of Lachkova. Every time you can see Mei Yamaguchi trying to close that distance, Lachkova's moving out and throwing that right hand of hers. She's not throwing any kicks either. She's not giving Mei Yamaguchi a chance to catch any kicks, and she's throwing just hands at this point.
Even though we are sold out here at the Ryo Goku Koku Gigan, very quiet. The Japanese are renowned as the most educated martial arts fans in the world. They sit there, they soak it all in, all the techniques, and their deep appreciation for the martial arts. In what many people believe and call, amongst myself, the spiritual home of the martial arts. And it's great to have one championship here for the very first time. Single leg lock on from Mei Yamaguchi.
Good job by Mei Yamaguchi to get connected here as she approaches that single leg. She was finally able to duck under some of these punches from Lachkova, close that distance, grab onto that single leg. Look how Lachkova's got that overhook on her right side. She's trying to keep the posture nice and high so Mei Yamaguchi's not able to drop down, change levels, and at least try to circle around and get that double leg. There she goes, trying to get that double leg. Now her hands are almost locked. Lachkova's doing a good job of keeping her legs separated and also using the overhooks to control the posture of Yamaguchi and not enable her to drop down and lock those hands together. The defense, technically, from Lachkova.
Hello to all of our Japanese viewers watching tonight on TV Tokyo and Abema TV. Championship, the very first time in Japan. Turnaround here from Lachkova, backs Yamaguchi against the fence, crossing elbow from the Russian. Now it's Yamaguchi's turn, nicely done from Vivi.
You can see Yamaguchi has both underhooks. She's got two arms underneath the arms of Lachkova. And Lachkova has such good balance in that reach advantage, height advantage, she's able to stop a lot of the takedown attempts by Yamaguchi. Yamaguchi has to keep her back pressed up against the cage there, or Lachkova would have taken her back. Good job.
Here's the appreciation from the crowd here in Tokyo. Lachkova, who is renowned as a first-round finisher, three first-round finishers, has not come out as explosively tonight as we've seen her in the past. But this is her step up to the biggest stage of all, the largest martial arts organization in the world, one championship. And she's handling herself very well, I might say, Mitch.
Yeah, she's able to stop a lot of the takedown attempts, and that is a category of our judges' scoring, is takedown defense. And you can see how she's able to do it. You can see just then, Yamaguchi came in with the overhand right, tried to drop down that single leg, and Lachkova was able to spin her around, press her up against the cage, and now is doing very well inside the clinch.
20 seconds remains. There's the right hand. Now loading it up is Mei Yamaguchi. Traditional martial artist out of Japan against the Pancration World Champion. Takedown there. Final 10 seconds. Yamaguchi on her back. Elbows to the top of the head there from VV Mei Yamaguchi. 1 foot on hips, and that's how the round ends. It's wow. One championship, a new era, live from the Rio Goku Kokugikan in Tokyo, Japan.
Very impressive finish. Look at this, Mei Yamaguchi trying that overhand right. And look at that, she's able to keep her shoulder nice and tight to her chin and was able to deflect a lot of that power coming from Mei. But then, here in the exchange, Mei Yamaguchi lands that short left hand, but Lachkova, the towering kickboxer, was able to throw that overhand right and touch Yamaguchi on the chin. But more significantly, Lachkova was able to score a big takedown at the very end of that round and end the round in a very dominant position. Now, we don't score round by round, but at the first 5 minutes, Lachkova is looking very sharp in all the different areas.
We're ready to roll, second round of three. Between Ksenia Lachkova and Vivi Mei Yamaguchi. A magnificent scene inside this incredible building. The Gun, renowned as the Sumo Arena here in Japan. Its hallowed hallways have been walked by some incredible martial arts champions. Tonight, many of them on display, over 130 martial arts world champions in one championship. Yamaguchi comes up firing with the right hand. Inside leg kick, missed the target. Counter there from Lachkova.
This is what Mei Yamaguchi has to do. She has to make this dirty. She can't allow Lachkova to stand at her range and touch her up with those hands. She's got to get close. She's got to make it dirty. Throw that right hand. That's it. Get nice and tight now. How can she do it? She's got to change levels, drop down, tack that single leg. Good defense from Lachkova. The way she's able to utilize these overhooks to control the position of Yamaguchi is very impressive. Yamaguchi is incredibly strong inside the clinch. Again, she's a judo black belt.
Inside leg there, drops down. Locks onto a single leg. Does Yamaguchi, can she affect the takedown? Can she get the Russian on her back? It was Yamaguchi who was on her back at the end of the opening round. As Mitch said, Lachkova doing a lot right so far here tonight.
See, she's utilizing that underhook to keep Mei Yamaguchi posture nice and high and keep her from dropping down. She's even trying to lace these legs and go for the takedown. Lachkova might have grabbed the takedown there. Might have stopped the takedown by grabbing the fence, but eventually Yamaguchi was able to get it.
Close guard from Ksenia Lachkova. 3:20 remains. Second round of three. throws that close guard up a little higher now, does let go over. Let's see if Mei can posture up, break it open, land some ground and pound. Postures up now, does Mei, the hands are locked up for the moment. Tries to get the right hand free, wants a hammer fist strike. And again, close guard, opens it, closes it again, does let go over.
See, Laskova's trying to pin down one of these arms, look for an armbar.
Yep, there she goes, throw the hips up.
And as we see, this is a big high on the arm. You can see the elbow is almost out. She might be able to pop it out, but she's got to, you know, because of the length of Lachkova, she's able to attack a lot of these positions.
And that predicament is Mei Yamaguchi. Still top position here for the Japanese martial artist. Good right hand there for Yamaguchi. Snake bend of the schnoz of Lachkova, then goes to the body.
Lachkova's got a very active guard. You can see her. She's always trying to look for something. She's trying to pin down these arms, trying to lock one of those arms into place so she can start throwing those legs up.
Lachkova eats another right hand.
Good job from Mei Yamaguchi to control that top position. Not putting herself in any big danger, but she is starting to land some ground and pound as well.
Where does Lachkova go from here, Dragon?
I'd like to see Lachkova keep attacking these arms, keep attacking this arm like this. She's trying to pin down that arm like that, and she's going to try to go, try to swing one of these legs over and attack another arm bar again. Mei Yamaguchi is not going to make a mistake by putting her hands on the ground and give Lachkova the ability to shoot a triangle. But what we are seeing is I'd like to see Lachkova just separate here, put the feet on the hips of Mei Yamaguchi and start to push her away. But she keeps hunting for that arm bar.
Hammer fist there from Yamaguchi from inside the close guard of Lachkova. Ooh, goes to the bread basket. One up to the chest there from Yamaguchi. Three levels in three punches there from Mei Yamaguchi. 1 minute 15 remains. Little peppering shots on the side of the jaw there from Mei. And Lachkova looks to clump towards her corner. They're giving her instructions here, the Russian.
Lachkova's looking for the finish. She's trying to throw those legs up. See how high her guard is? She's looking for this, but Mei Yamaguchi's not making really any mistakes to give Lachkova the opportunity to throw that submission in.
Mei Yamaguchi, one of six Japanese competitors on tonight's card. Can she give Team Japan a great start here inside the Rio Goku Koku Gikan for one championship, a new era? Hiroki Akimoto up next, Senzo Akeda later on. Of course, Ken Hasegawa still coming. So Yuya Wakamatsu against Demetrius Johnson. Big lineup, big night for Japan. Two punches, then one to the bread basket from Mei Yamaguchi. We do have another Russian on the card too later on, in the form of Timofey Nastukin taking on Eddie Alvarez. Don't sleep on Nastukin. When he goes beast mode, Eddie Alvarez had better keep his hands up.
Good ground and pound coming from Mei Yamaguchi. Very calculated strategy here on the ground. She's picking her shots, and she's doing just enough work to stop the stand-up from Kemp Chang.
In Tokyo, Japan, third and final round here between Mei Yamaguchi and Ksenia Lachkova. How do you see it so far, Dragon?
It's pretty close at this point. There was a lot of effective ground and pound coming from Yamaguchi. I think at this point, it's got to come down to these last 5 minutes on who can turn it up the most and clinch this victory in one of the biggest cards in history.
Jab two there from Lachkova. Seemed to be a bit more gusto from Yamaguchi coming out of her corner. Can she get on the inside of the reach of Lachkova? Maybe find range with that overhand right. There it is. Just caught the shoulder, though, the lead shoulder of the Russian.
See, watch how Lachkova's stance is. She's always bringing her left shoulder nice and close to her chin, and that's been able to deflect a lot of the shots from Yamaguchi.
Completely different builds between these two martial artists. Counter right hand there from Yamaguchi, throws the right down the corridor again.
And that right hand was able to connect because Lachkova switched to southpaw and it opened her up for that shot.
Yamaguchi wants to drop down, see if she can take Lachkova onto her back. Good right down the chair. Nice ball there from Yamaguchi. Crowd response to it. Now starting to find Wayne with the right hand. There's a double one from Yamaguchi. And a takedown. I love it. Inside the Rio Goku Koku Gikan.
Now Yamaguchi's starting to feel the moment and she's realizing that this is still her match to get, and she's able to do a lot of good work here in the third round. Beautiful right hands landed by Yamaguchi.
Top position here as she ended out the previous round. Little hammer fist there from Yamaguchi. Knocking down the wrists is Klutchkova. Another one there to the orbital. 3 minutes and five remains. Third and final round, Russia versus Japan, as Klutchkova tries to lock on for an arm.
Finally able to get it. She was looking for it the entire time, but it looks like Yamaguchi is able to use Klutchkova's attempt at a triangle to get the pass, and now sits inside side control.
Over the shoulder ahead. And this crowd sold out already here in San Dario. Goku Kokugigan is loving it every time Yamaguchi lands.
Man, typically, Michael, the Japanese crowds are so quiet, but even their sense of the moment, the magnitude of this card, and they're getting into it.
Since this card was announced, I believe it was last October, the buzz has been incredible. And over the last week, it has reached fever pitch here in Tokyo.
Nice ground and pound still coming from VV Mei Yamaguchi. Now she's sitting in half guard, and Lashkova's got to do something to get back up. She's got about 2 minutes to work. Yamaguchi's got heavy top pressure at this point. Now she's trying to pin her left leg on the thigh of Klutchkova, and what she's gonna try to do is try to slide her right leg through the half guard, just like that, and sit into mount, and take the back, possibly, here, of Klutchkova, looking for an armbar.
Wow, that was beautiful. Mei Yamaguchi was able to find the finish. It didn't happen in the first, but it eventually happened in the third. Beautiful finish, submission victory for VV Mei Yamaguchi in her hometown of Tokyo, Japan, inside the guard. Look at this, ducks under the punches coming from Klutchkova, chases down the double leg, and then she was able to slide through the guard. There she has landed a big knee to soften Klutchkova up in side control. She passed into mount. You can see Klutchkova extending the arms, gift wrapping the arm bar. Mei Yamaguchi takes it home like Christmas and gets the finish. Look at this adjustment. There's the thumb. Watch the thumb. The thumb has to stay up. There's no place for Klutchkova to go except to tap her way out. Beautiful win from Mei Yamaguchi.
Let's go to Tom Lau to make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kent Chang, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 18 seconds in the third and final round. For your winner, by way of armbar, Mei Yamaguchi!
There are 6 Japanese warriors on tonight's card. Yamaguchi is the first, Aoki will be the final, and it's 1-1 for Team Japan in Tokyo. Yamaguchi versus Barlin. Yamaguchi in orthodox stance, Barlin in southpaw stance. Very famous name in traditional martial arts, of course, Yamaguchi. Gogen Yamaguchi, the cat. Study up on that guy, one of the real founders, pioneers of traditional karate.
Next left hand landed by Balin as Mei Yamaguchi was trying to close that distance. Yamaguchi spent 8 weeks in camp, and she's been working on chaining things together, going from striking to wrestling to that grappling game. She feels that she's going to have the advantages inside the scrambles. She thinks that she can outwork Balin in a lot of those scrambles if the thing does hit the ground.
Balin taking her time. Yamaguchi, we know she has every trick in the book up her sleeve. Single leg takedown here from Yamaguchi, and Balin puts her inside the guard.
Right away, Ballin starts to get to work. You can see her start to transition out. You can see her trying to push down the right arm there of Yamaguchi, but Yamaguchi was able to use that slight distraction, a momentary lapse in concentration from Ballin to start passing into the half guard. You can see her right leg pinning down the left leg of Ballin as she starts to work her way into half guard.
You feel a win here for Yamaguchi should propel her into another title shot for that atomweight crown.
See, Yamaguchi's trying to get nice and tight. Ballin's trying to get recover her guard back. Yamaguchi's just so heavy in the top pressure.
Popping right hand there from Mei Yamaguchi, then switches up the left hand. Half guard position here for VV Mei Yamaguchi. Jiu-jitsu and karateka. Yamaguchi, BJJ stylist, is Laura Ballin. I hear a lot about Argentina on the international mixed martial arts scene. Also a footballing nation. You want to feel really old, Mitch, just think of this. Last time they won the World Cup, 1986, 33 years ago. They were really old, right?
You remember it?
I do.
Okay,
Diego Maradona all the way. Still half guard position here, Mei Yamaguchi.
She's trying to use her shoulder just to kind of create that little bit of pressure on the head of Ballin. Ballin's doing a good job. You can see here comes an arm triangle. If Yamaguchi can keep her arm right there, she's gonna have an arm triangle right here. Yep, you can see her just kind of moving her way in nice and tight. Let's see if she can clear the half guard here of Ballin. Ballin's got that half guard, but the squeeze of Yamaguchi might be too much. Now Yamaguchi's gonna wanna take her right leg out and to apply a little bit more pressure so she can start turning away from Ballin to create a little bit deeper choke. But Ballin's, as long as she keeps that half guard, she might be able to, that's what Yamaguchi wanted. Yamaguchi's gonna try to slide that leg out. Now she can start turning deeper and deeper into the choke. Ballin's trying to create movement. She's trying to tap. She's trying to not tap. You're nice and tight. She's gonna wanna take her hand, her right hand, and put it next to the head of right there next to Yamaguchi, kind of answer the phone is what it's called, just so she can keep that head from, or that arm from getting nice and tight, because essentially Mei Yamaguchi is choking Ballin with her own arm.
Still a lot of time remaining, 1 minute 30 of this first round. A great first round so far for Vivi Mei Yamaguchi. Doing everything right, neon belly there from Mei. Looks for the full mount here on Ballin. A bit of ground and pound from the Japanese warrior. Switches up hands, goes for an armbar now. Can she find the armbar? Yes, she does. First round finish, Vivi Mei Yamaguchi. You are awesome.
We said, you know, Mei said that she's been working on chaining things together. She had the arm triangle. Look at that beautiful moment of respect between these two female warriors. She realized this is black belt level experience, Michael. She had the arm triangle in deep, but rather than try to squeeze and gas her arms out or exert any unnecessary pressure, she chose to go back into mount and then go after the arm bar. Just a beautiful transition of chaining different submissions together. Watch the left leg. She slides that left knee up by the head of Ballin, able to put herself into proper position, and then goes after it. Then she turns her body to the side. Watch this. This is textbook right here. Gets that arm into proper position. Watch the thumb of Ballin. Realize the thumb is down. The thumb's supposed to be up. Mei realizes this, and she angles her hips to the side. See how she puts herself onto her left side to create that torque in the arm bar? Beautiful submission by Mei.
VV Yamaguchi. Here's Tom Loud to make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 46 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of armbar, Mei Yamaguchi.
VV Mei Yamaguchi again in the winner's circle. The Japanese flag flies high in Singapore tonight. Win by submission armbar against a BJJ specialist in the very first round for Mei Yamaguchi.